Hi everyone, welcome to the Java course. When we create our own methods, we can make use of the format like method name followed by the parameter list. And actually, can we have another method having the same method name? Yes, actually, but we have to have a different parameter list. And this issue is known as method overloading. So let me discuss method overloading by means of the example of a clock. Suppose I have a clock, and I have two instance variables which are private, hour and minute. So a clock will be able to show the hour and minute. And if I want to set up the time for that clock, I can have the set time method like this. I pass the value coming from the constructor to the instance variables. So I will be able to set the time for my clock. But if I want to set up a more precise clock with the information of the seconds, I need to create another method to set the time with three input parameters. So before doing so, I have to create one more instance variable called second. Now I create a create a method to set up a more precise clock. That would include the information about the second. Okay, in this set time method with three input parameters, I'm able to set the hour, minute, and second instance variables whose values are given by the actual parameters of hour, minute, and second when we really call the method. So what does it mean by method overloading? It is the situation where we have the same method name but with different input parameter lists. For the first set time method, I simply have two instance variables. But for the second set time method, I have already three input parameters. So this is known as method overloading. When we learn method overloading, it is quite useful for us to learn one more thing, which is known as method signature. Okay, for the set time method here, which is the first set time method, it has the method signature as set time bracket int. What does it mean by that? This is the method name, and for this method name, I have two input parameters. The first one is an integer primitive, and the second one is also an integer primitive. So by the same token, the second setTime method will have another method signature like this. Okay, for the second setTime method, the method signature is setTime bracket int. So it has three input parameters, all of which are integer primitives. So as long as the input parameter lists are different, we say that the setTime method is now overloaded. So overloading means we have same method name but with different parameter lists. But we have to notice something. The method signature does not include the return type of the method. So I won't say something like this. I won't say the method signature is void set time int int. The return type is not included. The reason is that if I have another method that has two input parameters, like I'm not able to have let the computer decide which method to use. So let me say a simple example. Suppose I have another method called setTime with the same parameter list as the first setTime method. I will get the compile time error because I have to rename the second setTime method. Why? Because the method signature does not include the return type. If I have two functions having the same parameter list but with different return types, it is impossible for the computer to decide which method to use when you call the setTime method with two integer primitives as the input parameters. So the computer is not able to choose which of the return type to use when you have the same method name but and with two same parameter lists. So we have to notice that the method signature does not include the return type. If we include the return types, it is impossible for the computer to decide which function to use when we have this same pattern of the input parameter list. Okay. Let me try to run the driver class, save it first. I have a simple clock. What does it mean by a simple clock? It means that I simply call the default constructor of the clock class. Why will I call a default constructor? Because I don't set any other constructors explicitly. In this case, I will make use of the default constructor. So the object is created in this way. And for this simple clock object, I use the setType method with two actual parameters. So 30 means the hour, 34 means the minute. Okay, let me save it and run it first. Yes, I can't see the object because I don't print it out. Let me try again. Yes, I can print out the statement because I already set up a toString method. Okay. This toString method is simply returning the value coming from the private instance variables. And let me try another one. I want to set up a precise clock with the information about the second as well. Here for the precise clock, I use the setTime method with three input parameters. So I have three formal parameters to represent the hour, minute, and seconds. And then let me print the toString method coming from the precise clock. Okay, because my toString method is still the original one, I still get the hour and minute as the answer. If I want to describe the seconds, I have to change the toString method here. Okay, let me try again. Yes, for this precise clock, I will get the toString method like this. I have all the information about the hour, minute, and second. And for the first simple clock, the second instance variable would become 0, which is the default value for instance variables if I haven't changed it at all. So that's the way we use different set time methods whose input parameters are different. And the reason I include the toString method is that I want to distinguish between method overloading and method overriding. The toString method is actually overriding the original toString method inherited from the object class. So when we create our own class, the toString method is already inherited from the object class already. If we want to change the toString method, we have to do the overriding action to change the content to what you like. So what's the difference between method overriding and method overloading? Method overloading involves different method signatures. So, for example, the setTime methods are having different signatures. Why? The first one has two input parameters, but the second one has three input parameters. So when the signature is different, we actually overload the method. But how about method overriding? Method overriding changes the implementation of the method with the same signature. So originally, the object class has already given us the toString method, which returns a string reference. When we want to create our own toString method, we do the overriding action by implementing the original toString method inherited from the object class. So in this case, I'm going to implement my own toString method by returning such a string. So in this case, I simply change the implementation of the method that has the same name and same input method signature. And of course, for the toString method, the return type is string. And when I want to override the toString method, I have to maintain the same return type as the string reference. So that's the fundamental difference between method overriding and method overloading. So I hope you're able to understand the mechanism of method overloading shown by the setTime method. And I hope that you're also able to distinguish between method overloading and method overriding. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, feel free to leave your comments on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.